Hello and welcome to Meet the Boss TV. There's been much discussion recently about the difference between a traditional multi-channel approach and the new omni-channel model. Some don't really see any distinction between the two, but luxury and sporting goods powerhouse Kering knows better. The explosion in channels, platforms, devices and other consumer touchpoints, not to mention the huge volumes of data produced as a result, has fundamentally changed the way that companies approach the customer. Since rebranding from PPR to Kering, the owner of brands such as Gucci, Saint Laurent, Stella McCartney and PUMA has been focusing on an omni-channel approach that aims to develop closer relationships with consumers and present more of a seamless experience across its entire portfolio. How? By leveraging data. Why? Because customers are already operating that way.
Customers are omni-channel. If you ask them what omni-channel means, they don't know, but they do. They interact, they gather information, they shop in different way, and that's evolving quicker and quicker. So if you want to create and maintain a relation with our customer, you of course you need to deal with this complexity, which doesn't mean you need to use them all the channels, but you need to define the way you want to use them all, or which one you want to use to do what. You don't need to duplicate the same kind of experience everywhere, but you can use, like, I don't know, Twitter as a customer service channel if you wish, as well as a sales channel, as well as a communication channel, as well as a corporate channel. So it's one single channel can mean many different things depending what your brand stands for and the way you want to interact with your customers. So that's why, to me, omni-channel is the future, and that's the difference between omni-channel and monichannel, in my opinion.
For Barbieri, it's all about having a holistic understanding of consumer behavior.
It's key, is where you start. As we said in the beginning, the omni-channel exists, or it's a strategic priority with companies because consumers are omni-channel. They do different things at different moment of the time of the day, of the week, of their life cycle with your brand, of even based on your culture and the city where you live. So understanding that, putting that at the heart, it's key. The second thing is, like, put somebody who's in charge of it. Because not just like a nice statement being client-centric, you need to make sure when you decide that you're good at customer satisfaction in a more omni-channel environment, that means that customer is happy about any opportunity you gave him or her to interact with you. Plus there are, like, roles. I mean, it's a complexity, so you cannot do everything everywhere in the same way. I mean, there are touch points that the customer want to interact with you. There are touch points where the customer just want to receive information with you, and other touch points where he wants to make business with you. So, okay, you need to define these roles, and these roles change. Like, you have a brand like, I don't know, Bottega Veneta, which is a top luxury, and Volcom, which is like a cool brand in the windsurf and skateboard world, of course. Probably the role of social can be totally different, as a simple example.
Today's consumer is empowered, informed, and connected. And in such an environment, data becomes critical in being able to deliver the right customer experience. So what role can analytics play in generating insights, improving offerings, and enhancing the brand experience?
Two ways. One, I believe, is useless, and the other one is very useful. I mean, if you're a premium brand, you lead the pace. So you don't create your collection or your proposition based on customer insights. You do that based on inspiration, because you want to deliver a proposition that doesn't exist. That's why you're a leader. And so that's the risk, is like to fall in love with too many information that may lead you to a mediocre offer, just because data show you what happened, not what will happen. On the other hand, it's the thermometer. Is your, like, instruments, you're on sailboat, and you need to watch all these data, because they help you to understand if you're going quicker than your competitors, if you're going in the right direction. So now these amount of information are much more than what it used to be. Most of the time they're not organized. So having a complete and effective set of dashboards will help the top management to understand if they are on the right route, in order to unleash their imagination to create new proposition and see if they're already taken to the next place. So it's in a way you let them go, and the other way you control. The other thing is, like, it's not a thermometer to read your business. It is also a thermometer to feel the temperature with the customer mind. Most of the time, I mean, you can save relationship with customer, you can put focus in your organization, because people tell you something about you, not directly, but indirectly, thanks to, of course, the information they can share among friends or other platforms in the space. So organize yourself in order to make this mess like effective. Of course, it is important, but it's not the solution to your success in the future. So you need to have both, unleash imagination and keep an eye on what's happening. Last but not least, I like also the definition of small data, because sometimes when you talk about big data, there's a huge amount of information. And by default, the huge amount of information is mass.
Yeah.
Instead of me and you, we are individual with our personal taste. Even if, if from the demographic or from other type of information, we may look much more similar. So small data are these peculiar and qualitative information which are very hard to get by any sort of scan of the web. In the sport and lifestyle, if you can look, I mean, I'm specialist, like you take a runner, I'm an amateur runner, professional runner, they're so different type of runner, your body weight, the frequency of your training, etc., etc. That will make your proposition very precise to that particular customer, and the experience you build around them is perfect for that person only. By the time you start applying the same thing to the other one, then you failed. And then the same person in a different culture, you may fail again just because you want to deliver the same thing in a different way. As to say, like, there is a lot of complexity that we need to handle, and omnichannel just bring it up. Like, you know, loud way. If you want to manage all these beautiful opportunities you have around here, they are tough decisions to make. I mean, an organization to build and a little lack of flexibility that you need to take into consideration, because one solution won't fit them all.
For more fantastic interviews directly related to your business, be sure to explore Meet the Boss TV.